Hello, fellow educators, and welcome to the Making HEADway Classroom series. My name is Camarine, a STEM educator from Science Center Singapore, specializing in mathematics and chemistry for grades 7 to 10. With me today is Lian, an experienced teacher who has been teaching science and physics for over a decade. We are currently in the Science Center's Tinkering Studio, where we hold experimental workshops for students and the public. Together, we'll be guiding you through how to tinker with solar panels.
This video series is an integral component of the HEAD Foundation's Making HEADway ecosystem, a comprehensive open access collection designed to enhance the professional development of educators across Southeast Asia. Check out more free resources by clicking the link provided in the description below. You can also find our lesson plan contribution from Broadrick Secondary School in the teaching handbook, Becoming Leaders in Sustainability Education.
Did you know that you can harness the power of the sun right here? Not just as a distant star that lights up our day, but as a tangible, renewable source of energy. This is the essence of solar panel tinkering, an exploratory approach to understanding how energy can be generated and utilized. Solar energy, a boundless and clean power source, has been harnessed by civilizations for centuries. From ancient sundials to modern photovoltaic cells, little did those early innovators realize that their exploration of the sun's potential would pave the way for today's technological advances in sustainable energy and electrical systems. So join us as we delve into how solar panel technology can illuminate the principles of energy transformation and conservation for your students, making science both accessible and thrilling. Together, we will explore how a practical exploration and engineering project can spark curiosity and inspire the next generation of eco-conscious innovators.
Our journey will span several key topics, including energy conversion, the role of conductors and insulators, and the intricacies of electrical systems. These concepts are aligned with the curricula for primary 6 science, as well as lower secondary science for secondary 1 and secondary 2, or grades 7 and 8. By the end of this video, our hope is that you'll feel confident in guiding your students through a hands-on exploration-based lesson that imparts key knowledge on solar energy and the engineering process.
As we prepare students to explore and experiment with solar panels, each student pair should have at least 2 solar panels ranging from 2 volts to 5 volts to allow for some experimentation. You'll also need a minimum of 6 crocodile clips for easy tinkering purposes, a couple of DC motor fans to demonstrate the conversion of solar energy into mechanical energy, and at least 1 supercapacitor to explore energy storage. Digital multimeter is optional. I highly recommend it for a deeper understanding of electrical measurements. And if you're doing this experiment indoors, don't forget a powerful light source like a floodlight, which we are using today to simulate sunlight. These items can be easily sourced or purchased online if you don't already have them in your school's science lab.
These are the objectives of today's lesson. We will first understand the vital concepts of energy conversion and the directional flow of electric currents through practical experimentation. Then we'll dive into the potential and limitations of solar energy as a renewable resource while tinkering with various setups. By adjusting the size of our panels and experimenting with different connections, we aim to gain a deeper understanding of energy conversion and the intricacies of electrical systems. Finally, we'll explore how these circuits can be integrated into energy storage systems for real-world application. Before we dive into the hands-on activities, it's important that everyone has a solid understanding of certain foundational concepts like power and the different forms of energy. Please take a moment to review the worksheet to refresh these concepts in the description box. In today's lesson, our teaching techniques will focus on learning by doing and facilitation rather than traditional didactic teaching. This approach encourages critical thinking and problem solving. Of course, in situations where safety is a concern, teachers should give explicit instructions to ensure a safe learning environment for everyone. We'll walk you through how this is done.
Now that we have our materials ready, let's dive into the exciting part, energy conversion. Our goal here is to transform light energy into electrical energy, which in turn powers our DC motor fan, converting it into kinetic energy. Using the solar panels, crocodile clips, DC motor fan, multimeter, and your light source, think about how you can set up your equipment to demonstrate this conversion. This is the start of the tinkering process. We jump right in. I challenge you to tinker with these components and figure out the best way to get that fan spinning. You have 10 minutes to explore and experiment. Feel free to pause this video and resume once you've had some time to try things out.
During this hands-on exploration, teachers should move around, ready to support, encourage, and guide students through their tinkering experiments. For the self-guided exploration to be effective, refrain from providing a step-by-step tutorial or revealing the end setup too early. This method ensures students are actively engaged and are leading their own learning experience. For those less familiar with the intricacies of motors, wire connections, and circuits, it might be more beneficial to offer more focused assistance after they have a chance to explore. Also, fostering an environment where students can learn from each other is incredibly valuable. Allow some time for consolidation, observations, and troubleshooting if required. For the purposes of this lesson, we will be taking you through two problem scenarios that you or your students may encounter when carrying out these experiments.
The first common problem encountered: why does the DC motor fan not work when the connections are made to the rubber parts? What properties of rubber might affect the outcome? That's right, the rubber acts as an insulator, preventing the electrical current from passing through to the motor. This is a great reminder of our study on conductors and insulators. Another question to ask students is, why do you think the DC motor fan spins in the opposite direction to your peers? The direction in which the motor fan spins is determined by the polarity of the connections to the solar panels. This ties back to our lesson on electrical systems and helps understand how reversing connections can change the direction of an electrical motor.
Recall the two teaching strategies we are using: learning by doing and facilitation over instruction. When going around to assist students in their tinkering, try using open-ended questions to stimulate their thinking, like Camarine has just asked. Then try relating their observations back to the curriculum to solidify understanding on key concepts.
Building on what we've learned so far, it's time to dive a little deeper into the variables that can influence the operation of our solar-powered DC motor fan. During the second exploration stage, ask your students to consider the different ways they can manipulate the current setup to adjust the speed of the motor fan. Allow them some time to explore and tinker around on their own again, before stepping in with facilitation questions. As a reminder, do not provide students with too specific instructions before they start tinkering, as this may limit their exploration. Reserve facilitation questions for when students are stuck.
Remind your students to make notes of what they observe as they test each variable. Documenting their findings will not only help them keep track of the experiments, but will also enhance their understanding of how each factor contributes to the system's performance. So take a moment now to pause this video and embark on your investigative journey.
Now, Lian Siong is going to put an interesting spin on things. Let's see how using panels of different sizes affects the speed of the motor fan. Lian Siong, after switching between the different sizes of solar panels, what did you notice about the behavior of the DC motor fan?
Well, it was quite clear. The larger the solar panel I used, the faster the motor fan seems to spin.
Exactly. And why do you think that happens?
I assume it's because larger solar panels can capture more sunlight, right?
You're spot on. When comparing similar types of solar panels, larger ones have a greater surface area, allowing them to absorb more sunlight and thus generate more solar energy. This is a perfect demonstration of how the size of solar panels is directly linked to their output. Now that we've seen the impact of solar panel size, what are some other ways we might tinker with our setup to vary the speed of the motor fan?
Based on our experiments, I believe we could experiment with changing the light intensity, adjusting the distance between the light source and the panel. Test different panel sizes to confirm observations. Explore wiring configurations. For instance, setting up solar panels in series or parallel to see how that affects output. Try different types of light sources to see the type of lights affects the speed and adjust the orientation of the panel relative to the light source for optimal energy absorption. Keep these variables in mind as the students move through the tinkering process so you are prepared to facilitate.
Our exploration has shown us the incredible potential of solar panels in converting sunlight to electricity, powering devices like our DC motor fan. However, it's also critical to understand and acknowledge the limitations that come with using solar energy. What do you think are some challenges we might face with solar power?
Well, one obvious challenge is what happens when there's no sunlight, like at night or during cloudy and rainy days.
Precisely, that's what we refer to as solar intermittency. It's a great term to remember because it underscores one of the fundamental limitations of solar energy. It's not continuously available.
And to really understand this concept, let us do a quick demonstration. If you all watch closely as I move my hand gradually across the floodlight, you will see the light intensity on the solar panel changes. Notice how as the light becomes blocked, the speed of our DC motor fan slows down. This simple action simulates the effect of cloud cover passing over the sun. It's a direct, observable way to understand how the availability of sunlight impacts the efficiency of solar panels and, by extension, the generation of electricity.
This intermittency presents a significant challenge for relying solely on solar power for our energy needs. It emphasizes the importance of energy storage solutions like batteries and the need for a diversified portfolio of renewable energy sources to ensure a stable and reliable supply. Understanding these limitations is just as crucial as recognizing the potential of solar panels. It helps us think critically about the design and implementation of renewable energy solutions in our real-world energy needs.
So, how can we overcome this limitation? Well, one of the most effective ways to address the intermittency issue of solar power is by using a supercapacitor. A supercapacitor acts somewhat like a rechargeable battery, but it has the ability to charge and discharge energy much faster. It's designed to store electrical energy temporarily by accumulating electric charges.
Considering the technical nature and safety concerns of working with supercapacitors, I'll guide you through the connection process. It's crucial to follow these instructions carefully to avoid any potential hazards, such as a fire risk due to wrong wiring. First and foremost, remember that supercapacitors have polarity, meaning they have a positive and a negative terminal. You can usually identify the negative terminal by looking for the side with two parallel stripes. This is consistent with the supercapacitor we're using today. Always check the specification sheet of your supercapacitor for detailed information on storage and usage. A few important safety precautions. Never connect a supercapacitor to a power source that exceeds its rated voltage. For example, a supercapacitor rated at 5.5 volt should only be charged with a power source of 5.5 volts or lower. Additionally, avoid short-circuiting the terminals and ensure the supercapacitor is fully discharged before storage.
The principles we are exploring here are not just theoretical, they are real-world applications. Across the globe, energy storage systems, or ESS, utilize technologies similar to supercapacitors to overcome the challenges of renewable energy sources like solar and wind by storing excess energy when production is high and releasing it when demand increases. ESS ensures a stable and reliable power supply. These systems are crucial for balancing grid demand, preventing outages and supporting consistent power delivery to both industries and homes.
As we conclude today's lesson on solar panel tinkering and the integration of supercapacitors, let's take a moment to recap some of the essential teaching tips that can make lessons like these both engaging and educational for our students.
Firstly, remember that tinkering is a process that involves trial and error. It's important to allocate sufficient time for students to think, explore, and engage with the materials. Providing a variety of materials for tinkering not only accommodates different learning styles, but also encourages creativity and innovation. More materials means more opportunities for discovery,
Asking open-ended questions is a key strategy to prompt students' thinking without giving away the answers. This approach encourages critical thinking and problem-solving skills, essential components of scientific inquiry. It's crucial to follow the students' lead during tinkering activities. Allow them to try, fail, and try again. This resilience in the face of failure is a critical learning outcome in itself, fostering a growth mindset.
Making connections between the activity and the curriculum, or even better, to real-life applications, helps students understand the relevance and importance of what they are learning. It shows them the practical implications of their studies beyond the classroom. For students who grasp concepts quickly or are looking for more of a challenge, offer more complex tasks or encourage them to delve deeper into the subject matter. This ensures that all students remain engaged and motivated. Finally, encourage peer-to-peer support. Learning from and teaching one another is a powerful tool for reinforcing understanding and building collaborative skills.
Creating this lesson on solar panel tinkering has been an incredibly rewarding process. From the initial brainstorming stages to the final implementation, every step has been a testament to the power of collaborative effort and innovative thinking. The opportunity to design a hands-on learning experience, one that moves beyond traditional classroom boundaries and into the realm of active exploration, has been both challenging and exhilarating. Seeing my colleagues come together, each contributing their unique insights and expertise, has been a profound reminder of the impact we can make as educators. It's been a journey of discovery not just for our students, but for us as well.
Watching our students engage with the materials has been one of the most gratifying aspects of this lesson. Their progress from initial curiosity to deep, meaningful understanding speaks volumes to their dedication and our approach. The active participation in work, the critical thinking demonstrated through the tinkering activities, and their enthusiastic feedback all serve as powerful affirmations of our teaching methodology. Students not only grasped the technical aspects of solar energy and circuitry, but also embraced broader environmental implications. The feedback, filled with insights and personal reflections, underscores the lesson's impact on their perception of renewable energy and its role in our world.
Thank you for joining us on this journey of discovery. For more insights and innovative teaching methods, visit the links in the description. See you soon!